Asia, what was the problem that you had when you came to New Day last year?
I was in the middle of getting diagnosed with POTS, which is a condition that causes a lot of dizziness and fainting.
So this is a condition you were telling me that had been getting worse over the years, but then it was getting worse quite quickly before you came to New Day.
Yes, it started off when I was 12, and I just felt a couple of dizzy spells every couple of months, but by 15 I was fainting 2 to 3 times a week.
Wow. So Kezia was telling me earlier she was fainting 2 to 3 times a week with this condition that's called postural orthostatic tachycardia syndrome. This is a scary condition. What's it like, Kezia, to live in a body that could faint at any minute?
Terrifying. I wasn't allowed to go out alone. I had to be with an adult at all times. It was just, I was locked in my body and I couldn't get out, and I felt really depressed about it.
You were telling me sometimes when you fainted in the street, one time you hit your head and you went to hospital with this condition, eh?
Yeah, they had to call an ambulance several times because if I'd fallen and no one around me knew what was going on, it could be quite scary because I could be out for 5 or 6 minutes.
And I would have thought if you can faint at any minute, even having a bath would be scary because presumably you could drown?
Yeah, my parents had to check on me when I was in the bathroom and text me just to make sure I was still awake.
So this is an awful situation, an awful life to live where any minute you could drop down and faint. But you came to New Day last year, and since then, let me just ask you, in the last year, you were fainting twice a week, twice a day when it was at its worst. Have you fainted in the last year?
No.
And I know that you went back to see, it was Dr. Schmidt was your specialist, you were telling me. She'd been seeing you for about 3 years. What did she say when you went back to see Dr. Schmidt? What did she make of what had happened to you?
She just couldn't understand, and she kept saying, like, I don't get this, like, why has this happened? And because I had a week-long heart monitor and nothing showed up on it, and they had to sign me off the hospital.
Marvelous. It's a great story. And one of the things that's most exciting about what's happened to Kezia is that you had this heart monitor previous, so you'd had a previous heart monitor test, so they had a before and after, hey?
Yes, and the first one showed a little bit of, it wasn't an even, and it showed a little bit of a murmur, but that's gone now.
And so you had the before test that showed your heart conditioned all over the place, and then the one that you've had since is clear. But she was also saying to you that this is a condition that isn't expected, you weren't expected to recover. It was a lifelong condition, is that right?
Yeah, there's no cure. I would have had to live with it my whole life, and there's no medication.
Wow. Fantastic. Thank you, Kezia. That's great. Thank you.